Hello and welcome. My name is Alexander. I'm a freelancer. Here you have my contact information, website, email, Android app. So I should mention kind of services which I provide to my clients. Software development, creating unit tests, helping to analyze complexity of the software, training, creating workshops, and helping people to find jobs. So basically, I do a lot of different kind of things, not only software development. So let's try to speak about what is on the agenda today. Today I want to present you a pattern which is a command pattern. What you see is a kind of reference from this book. I should always mention this book because it is major point from where you can learn design patterns, and I always happy to say where I get an idea from. So it is all about command pattern and how it works. You have 1, 2, 3, 4 major classes. You have client instance. The client instance give an order of the food which somebody wants to order. Waitress goes and put the order on the list. From that list, a diner store, actually it should be mentioned, not the diner store, but actually the cook, kind of quick update, the cook gets the list of the orders, cook the meals, and then notify the waitress, and the client then get from the waitress the ordered food, done food. So, and basically the major idea to have clean separation. So basically here the client does not know how the food is cooked, he just provides the order, and the waitress actually don't know how the food is done. It puts the list of ordered food list onto the list. And from the list, the cook takes it, as soon as it is available, takes it and then cook it and send it back to the waitress. And the waitress know, okay, the food is done, now I bring the food to the client. So basically, it's a major idea about common pattern from the book, which I have mentioned previously, and how it looks as a UML diagram. In the terms of major Gang of Four book of design patterns, you have your client, receiver, concrete command as interface, and then the invoker. And how it all tied up, I have pretty simplified example of command pattern. I do not like to go into the deep with this kind of pattern. And you see is a test. So basically I'm testing, can I create cook, can I create waitress, can I create my customer, and then I test the behavior, the expected behavior. So I test if my cook can make fries, can make burger, so such and such. Here's most interesting stuff. So waitress should forward the order, so I'm using a lambda expression, so if you don't know it, look it up. And it goes like this. In the lambda itself, I'm creating the list of orders. The list of orders gets access the cook object. So basically I'm calling the cook object and making sure that it cooks for me, and then it brings to my list of orders the done food. It's not one-to-one examples which I show to you in my diagrams, but you should get the idea about it. And if you want to improve this case, you can always look it up, my code on GitHub, and
do additional refactoring and testing. But major idea, I have a list. List gets the food. List provides the information which food should be done. And then when it's done, then it's done. I don't think that my customer gets actual access to the food. Let me look up the diner. Diner is it's a kind of test if I can access the stuff. So here I have my waitress, my customer, and here it goes. I have my list of orders. I put on my list of orders. So actually the diner knows about the order in this kind of case. But if I would write a more detailed example, actually diner would not know about the order. Shouldn't know about the order actually. Maybe I should actually refactor it, like, I don't know. I don't care. So, the diner is actually the way how this code provided from the book had first design patterns. It shows you that you have, you can cook the food from the diner. You have your customer and you have your waitress. The customer at the end of this class, it sends the order. So basically, I'm preparing my order for the customer, and the customer say I want exactly this order, but I think it should be this whole stuff should be in the customer, because actually customer is responsible for creating all the order, and then he calls the order food on itself, and then you have in your customer following. So I need to check that. It was kind of expected that I need to make sure that my order is not null, so that I have something. And only that it takes order, the waitress takes order from my customer. I'm not completely satisfied with presented code solution, I must say honestly, but it should work. So if I run my diner and diner Java application, you can see clearly making a burger, making a fries, and I should basically this is still valid scheme for exact understanding how it goes. So in the way how I done my code, actually waitress don't put anything. So basically waitress, let me just do that. Waitress, she takes, she receives the order from the client, from the customer. And the diner actually calls my client. And the client give an order to waitress, and when I look from my code, so here I'm calling, actually I don't need to call waitress here, and let's just try it out. Okay. So now I understand it more. So basically, here in the example, the diner calls the client. Client receives waitress, gives her an order, and order food is not So the meal, from where it gets the meal, it receives meal from the order. So basically, my order is responsible for delivering the food. But order, when you look it up my code, it's a interface. So it's maybe happens to during execution time. I mean, after all the classes are instantiated, they're happening the dynamically. So objects, when objects are created from the classes, they start to communicate which is each other. So it's I doing this kind of dynamically, and you can actually do some stuff like order, gives the food list to client. The client say okay, and forwards it to the waitress. Waitress, actually, I need to, yeah. So basically, it goes like this. Waitress, what doing waitress? Okay, waitress. Waitress calls, access the order, and uses order up. So basically, I think, yeah, take order, this order, yeah, I have has it a relationship. So I'm putting the order and return the order, order up. Order up functional interface. So and my order up okay, so my customer put the order, but the diner is the class where all the magic happens. So here I have my order, and here I need to create order list. So in this class order list, so diner accessing the list. List of orders, and here I create my orders through the cook, and cook returns back to the list of client orders, and this is what I am return, and using this kind of interface declaration type, I actually putting this to my customer back when he orders the food. So who this is a main class which where all stuff happens. I create my cook, create my waitress, create my customer. I put my waitress, I put the reference to my waitress to the customer. Then I create in my diner the list of orders, which then executes my customer. I'm not 100% satisfied with this code, but the main idea about common patterns that you have many different actions, and you invoke this kind, this and you invoke these commands more or less independently. So I think it is not so much clear what actually did happen, but if you look at this diagram, you have your client use receiver, inclined to use concrete command. And concrete command can actually use receiver too. And the interface, it's a contract between concrete command and invoker. And the major idea is to be able to use different commands in decoupled way. So basically in this diagram, client have no clue how the invoker looks like. So you can the main advantage, as I see, as with any design patterns, is decoupling and separation of the boundaries. So here you basically trying to achieve following that even if the invoker did changed, your REST architecture stay stable. So if invoker for some unknown reason changing, all of the other stuff still happens, still stable and working. But I think if you got an idea, it's good. If you're still puzzled, I say try to look it up, the not only my code, but actually the original explanation from the book. But I say it's all about decoupling. So you try to separate your client class from the implementation of the command button. The book itself presented an example with a remote control. So you have, for example, let me just draw some stuff. My Microsoft Draw. Yeah. So let me just create new stuff. So you have your remote control with many buttons. Yeah, I'm not so quite sure on drawing, but does not matter. So, and you have your caller. And caller puts finger on one button, push, and one event should be raised. But you have kind of separation. So the button object itself have no clue how actually event will be implemented. It forwards to one class, and this class, as I show you here, redirects to actual implementation. And this is my understanding of the command pattern. Maybe it's not 100% accurate, but I think I have I've got an idea. So command pattern allow you to decouple your stuff and be able to add additional behavior for your action which you have in your software architecture. Major drawback what actually can be is if you need to deal with, I don't know, many different type of commands, and I should pinpoint the amount of stuff. I don't know, here I have an example, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 buttons. It's kind of okay. But if you need to delegate commands of amount of 20, maybe it is good to say it is should be tested. Of course, the behavior of such buttons should be tested. But you should think about even with 20 or 40 different type commands which you need to handle. Does it make any sense? Does it really need to be done in command pattern way? And in the book, they provide an example which I would not right now show you, but it is in the book. They're mentioning a lot of different stuff which you can do, like for example, once again, threads. And threads can handle many command objects at different amount of threads. So you have your railroads. It's my understanding of the threads, railroads. And railroads, they are execution threads. So you have one program, but in one program you have many different execution how I should say it better. Yeah, you have one major cycle. Cycle is wrong word. Actually, it's like you want to execute at one at the same time many different types of execution. So it, and you pass the data between many separated threads, and with buttons and command button you can actually do such thing like one thread managing only four buttons, other threads managing another four buttons, and if the state between buttons should be shared, you should then deal with the threads passing values from one thread to another thread and to another thread. I should say you should be pretty cautious when you use threads, because threads in general can be pretty complex stuff. It should not have such complexity. Try to avoid that in your threads program. But as a last opinion about command pattern, I see the reason behind of it. I'm not sure that is always suitable to use it. I see the major disadvantage if you have, like, I don't know, 40 actions, and you wish to have it in command pattern way, and I'm not sure this is suitable for that. It allows you to make a general decoupling, because if you can decouple the implementation of the button, you can always change the behavior of the button due to this decoupling. So once again, I have this diagram of simplification of the command pattern, and my last attempt to say following: the command interface is a contract between concrete command and the invoker. Invoker, as you see, it sets the command. Concrete command, it is a place where the command is actually executed, and the client calls it, or call it actually through different class. And concrete command need to have a kind of receiver where the action happens, maybe storage, saving after execution the data. And client then, after receiver done the work, can access the state of the receiver, and this actually allow you, when you implement command pattern, the ability to make sure that at the later point of time you can change the behavior of your command. So this is what I want to provide to you, and be sure to check out my code if you think that I'm bubbled through, maybe. But this is my understanding of command pattern. It decouples the behavior of your command from the button, and it allow you to actually structure your code in the more cleaner way. But with every design patterns you have disadvantage, and I should always mention that using your design patterns, I mean the design patterns which you know, always think about disadvantage. What kind of a disadvantage I'm buying when I use a particular design pattern. So thank you for watching my video, and I hope that I present my next topic more cleaner way, not so much bubbling. But anyway, thank you, bye bye.